竹是工匠眼中的璞玉，雕琢世间百态，一展天工巧夺。 天目山路，黄浦江源，安吉，中国美丽乡村发源地，西子湖畔的诗画竹香，1886平方公里的土地，被绿色的竹子的海洋所淹没。竹守护着这方绿水青山，也是山民赖以生存的宝贵财富。
奉献敬碑是清朝嘉庆十三年立的，碑文内容大意是：
对这个盗挖东笋、乱砍笋行，做了严厉的禁止。在上面我们可以看到，无有匪徒窃笋情事，造例纠办。
在我们安吉，昨年要放大小年，把小年的笋要挖掉，把大年的毛笋养起来，这样就保证。 竹子的持续生长。
年复一年，竹林中的竹子不断的生长出来。每两年，在6月到9月，新生长起来的毛竹就要粘油。粘油就是在竹子上记上年生长年份，等将来砍毛竹，我们心里有数。再记上我们家的记号。
告诉别人，这是我家的毛竹，不要乱砍。竹枝繁茂，灌溉如伞。在安吉的雪冬，竹梢的积雪会让竹子压弯折断。于是，每年冬季来临之前，竹农会用特制的长杆镰刀削去竹梢和多余的旁枝，以保护竹子过冬。这就是钩梢。 竹林养护中相当重要的一道工序。竹农把砍下来的竹梢和竹枝搜集起来，捆扎成毛料贩卖。这些毛料是制作笤帚的上好材料。
预备，
开始呢。
经过5年的茁壮生长，竹子的质地紧密坚实，可以砍伐取用。这是竹农最主要的收获。每道竹子的采伐季，五湖四海的商贩纷纷进山收购。在没有地磅的时代，人们从大量的实践中总结发明了一套。 效率极高的圆竹计重方法，量竹，用专用的量竹尺，在特定的竹节丈量直径7寸、8寸、9寸，交易的双方在现场量竹计数，数百吨圆竹，仅需要几十分钟就能完成双方都认可的重量统计。 而随着现代计量技术的发展应用，量竹被更为精准的地磅称重所替代，成了逐渐远去的时代记录。在交通不便的古代，圆竹运输极为不易。智慧的人们将竹子扎成竹梯，标准的竹梯每扎重1000斤，方便大宗交易计量。 编成竹排，由经验丰富的放筏工们在激流险滩中撑起筏排，通过安吉遍布四境的溪条溪水系，运到码头进行交易。 安吉竹农最主要的收入来源。在原竹产销时代，以双村为代表，安吉竹农将传统的竹林养护措施和先进的毛竹风产技术相结合，形成了全国领先的科学育林标准，为安吉竹产业的发展奠定了厚实的林业资源保障。截止目前，安吉拥有竹林101万亩，毛竹立竹量1.7亿株。
改革开放以后，70-80年代，市场经济非常活跃。安吉呢，有一些竹粮洗竹供应厂。后来，台湾在安吉孝丰做了第一家机制竹粮洗厂。日本人和东光公司合作，开始生产竹笋罐头。最后面就有了竹纤维、竹地板、竹工机械等纷纷发展起来。安吉竹产业慢慢形成了整个产业链。
在安吉县委县政府、安吉县林业局等各部门的全局统筹下，全县1800余家竹产业企业强劲带动，安吉竹产业发展横跨8大门类，产品囊括竹粮席、竹地板、竹家居、竹纤维、竹工艺品、竹叶生物制品、竹笋食品、竹炭制品、竹工机械等近3000多个品种，全产业链年产值超200亿元。从卖原竹到进原竹，从用竹竿到用全竹，从物理利用到升华利用，从单纯加工到链式利用，安吉竹产业的发展历经了4次跨越，已仅占全国1.8%的立竹量，创造了占全国10%的竹业产值，助推安吉摘获中国10大竹乡之首、中国竹地板之都、竹粮席之都、竹纤维名城、全国乡村振兴林业示范县等一系列荣誉称号。在中国辽阔广袤的竹资源国土上，赢得了中国竹子看安吉的至高赞誉，成为引领中国竹产业发展的排头兵。竹，经霜暮雪而四季常绿，挺拔凌云却虚心有节。古往今来一直都是文人墨客、志士仁人的风骨自愈，更因在人们生产生活中的广泛应用，衍生了丰富多彩的竹文化。诗词歌赋、金石书画、建筑园艺、竹工艺品、饮食文化、竹乐、竹舞。张吴，吴昌硕故居所在。竹的艺术文化蕴养了大师诗书画印的四绝才情，也繁衍出丈吴竹扇这一世代传承的民间匠艺，成为造福一方的特色经济产业和城镇文化符号。今天的安吉竹产业的发展已经广泛地融入生态休闲旅游、美丽乡村建设、创意生态工厂、文创综合体等各种类型的新经济、新业态。竹资源、竹产业、竹文化紧密相依、相互融合。逐渐形成资源成就产业、产业促进文化、文化提升资源的人竹共生的立体生态发展模式。在安吉，一根竹子 从笋到竹，从干到叶，从资源到产业，从产业到文化，从有形到无形，综合价值得到了全面充分的开发利用。安吉竹产业逐渐形成全竹开发、生态循环、产业融合的发展定位和布局，夯实建设中国最美县域的生态文明，成为坚定两山发展理念的生动实践，积极融入新时代中国特色社会主义建设事业，为人民日益增长的美好生活需要源源不绝地创造世界竹产业领先的新产品、新服务，共筑竹美人和、竹兴民富的安吉梦、两山竹梦。
其后三本地界春秋今夜某鬼梦凶，无缘少学立志以云，若要为着天地垂根，以一股之源
在浙江西南部，有一片1898平方公里的绿色屋脊，这里的山与水柔然相依，绿树与百花浓郁葱茏，而青竹作为它的魂，也始终伴随着它悠久的岁月。它就是中国生态环境第一线、最生态窗口——浙江沁园。中国生态环境第一线，浙江沁园。
Qingyuan，你要不要翻一点 ？So this video is about the Qingyuan County.
山峦起伏，溪流纵横，气候湿润，物种丰富。百山谷国家级自然保护区沁园国家森林公园坐落在县域内，全县森林覆盖率达86%，是华东最大的天然氧吧。
Participants, this video is about Qingyuan County. The Qingyuan County locates in Zhejiang Province. It is an ecological county. One of the polar industries of the county is the bamboo sector.
中国特色竹乡，浙江。
It's a featured bamboo hometown of China.
必然离不开青山绿水。
It's a mountain, you can see it's a mountainous area with rich bamboo resources and a long history of bamboo utilization.
Qingyuan 有420,000亩竹林，6200多万株栗竹，是中国毛竹核心分布之一。
You see the Mosul bamboo forest distribution in the area is very concentrated. This is a very concentrated area.
2500多公里，形成4通8达的林间道路网络，积极推广新型试用技术与科研成果。
They apply some new technology in bamboo processing.
And
they also have the bamboo demonstration site
for bamboo management. 在第七届中国竹文化节上，沁园被授予中国特色竹乡。中国竹制品产业基地，浙江沁园。沁园始终坚持习近平总书记绿水青山就是金山银山的生态发展观，立足得天独厚的毛竹资源，在竹制品精神加工的创新道路上。
The size of the Mosul bamboo is quite big, and they were like managed in an industrial scale.
加工企业300余家，产品种类1000余种，年产值达30亿元，创造2万余个
行业。中国
竹文化龙头企业6家，国家知名商标涌现出来，以生产工艺竹筷为主的单箱木
器工程
厂，以生产定制竹家具为主的全国单项冠军企业有川竹木，生竹展开板、外贸竹品产品、竹叶小家具、竹棒竹竹单，获得全国单项冠军产品。政企合作成立浙江首家竹材重点企业研究院。双枪竹材研究院，已由国家高新技术企业20家参与制定国家竹制产品有关标准4项。经过40年持续发展，沁园形成产品种类齐全，产业链完善，科技含量高，规模优势强，品牌影响大的现代竹产业集群。
这是竹海公园，
浙江沁园，与辉煌共舞，与时代同行。沁园全面推进提升地产、竹工地产，发展三产的竹产业全产业链
，
在万物互联的新时代，竹产业发展拉上互联网加矿车道，全县竹制品销售网店1100多家。网络年销售总额近40亿元，连续5年入围全国电商百家县。一件件精美的竹制品， 从大山深处通过互联网销售到世界各地，让世界欣赏与品鉴到了庆元竹的动人之美。在未来竹产业发展蓝图中，以平都综合新区为主要载体，始终坚持技术创新驱动，建设绿色循环经济生态产业园，打造平都竹院特色小镇。不久的将来，竹文化主题公园、竹康养基地、竹林观光等项目落地建成。
It's about the future. They are going to establish a bamboo thematic park in Qingyuan County.
相信在这片绿色土地上，规划建设以龙头山为核心，含竹海观光、运动休闲、自驾越野等与竹文化相融合的世界竹海公园。而在今后的发展中，庆元竹也会为打造美丽浙江的最生态窗口添砖加瓦，为庆元的经济腾飞提供全新动力。
好的，那个副播差不多了，7:30了。
你介绍一下那个频道，英文、中文。
Okay, participants.We have provided interpretation services here. So if you could see that you could choose the Chinese channel and English channel. And so if you want to listen to English, please choose English China channel. And two of our panelists are going to speak Chinese. So make sure that you choose the right channel. 然后中文的咱们汉语的这个参会代表，请您选择一下那个中文频道，这样您可以在这个会议当中一直听到中文。好的，谢谢。
Dear friends, welcome to our bamboo industry development. Yeah. And today is the eighth session of our webinar.Since June, we have organized the 6 sessions for bamboo industry development. For example, innovation in knowledge, products, and markets. Three case studies of national bamboo industry development. Bamboo standardization and innovation.Production of bamboo charcoal, briquettes, and paint, and their applications.
你的英文还可以的啊。
Bamboo machine and equipment development. Bamboo machine and equipment development. Pulp, paper, and nature fiber. And bamboo-based panels and furniture.So today our session is the local bamboo development cases in China. Today we are happy to invite three speakers from three leading bamboo developing countries in China, Anji, Yong’an, and Qingyuan counties. They have abundant bamboo resources and a long history of bamboo use. Anji, Qingyuan, and Yong’an.Used their respective nature, social, and economic conditions to evolve different models for local bamboo sectors. This session will share this area's experiences in local bamboo sector planning and development to help other regions of the world to develop bamboo sector. So we hope there are more and more well-developed bamboo counties, regions, and countries. And this today, the first speaker is Mr. Zhang. Mr. Zhang is a senior engineer from Anji Forest Bureau, Zhejiang Province of China. He is an experienced expert in bamboo cultivation policies and the bamboo sector development policies. Mr. Zhang had been taking many positions, including standing council member of the China Bamboo Society, Zhejiang Provincial Bamboo Society, and the Bamboo and Rattan Utilization Branch of China Forest Society. Mr. Zhang's presentation is Anji Bamboo Industrial Development Experiences. Mr. Zhang, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. I really want to thank INBA for inviting me. I really want to thank Dr. Fu Jinghe and Professor Jingwei for giving me this great opportunity to talk about the bamboo industry development situation in Anji. I will talk about our experience and the lessons learned. Let's first of all look at the situation of Anji bamboo forest. 70% of the place is covered in forest. And among the 70% of the first land, 50% of the forests are bamboo forests. So they account for around 35% of the total land area. This is the wintertime situation. And you can see these are the mosul bamboo during the winter time. Now, allow me to talk about the situation of the bamboo products. This is the floor, the flooring, and also composite. And this is the bamboo mat. This is the machine made. They account for 60% of the total production. A lot of bamboo are made into sleeping mats. And this is bamboo shoots. And you can see dried bamboo shoots and processed foods loved by the people. These are bamboo lamps and raw bamboo building, and actually very popular among many counties and regions. People are using it to build country rooms and houses. These are some modernized bamboo furniture. You can see with bamboo plates, etc. China has a long history of tea culture. So you can see that a lot of tea wares are made from bamboo, and a lot of tea house furnitures are made from bamboo. This is the bamboo drinks. And also you can see bamboo leaf flavon is extracted from the bamboo leaves and can be processed and made into toothpaste, bamboo tableware. very popular type of products. Because now plastic is forbidden, so people are using bamboo to replace plasticware. Very popular too. Bamboo toothbrush. Bamboo charcoal. A traditional product of China with modern technology. And it is very eco-friendly. Bamboo chopsticks, very popular in the traditional culinary culture of China too. And, you know, Eastern culture use bamboo chopsticks all the time. And the bamboo fiber. Widely used in creative handicrafts. Now, I want to talk about the history of the bamboo industry in Anji. At the very beginning, I showed you a trailer about Anji. In the 1980s, we were only selling raw bamboo. In that process, we are using waterway to transport. We didn't have any roads, so Anji people were using the waterways to transport bamboo. We just shoulder by shoulder bring it to the foot of the hills and use the waterways to transport them outside of the mountainous areas. You can see some historic photos in older times. Many older governments, they were dredging the waterways and build canals to transport the bamboo. Now I want to show you the history of bamboo industry. Before 1980, we were using raw bamboo to make handicrafts and have general sales. You can see the women are weaving the bamboo baskets. Before 1980, that was a way to sell the raw bamboo. In order to transport the bamboo from 1952 to 1982, the government's putting a lot of money to build motorways. So since 1982, water transport was suspended, and most bamboo was transported on land. And now we are even now continuously building the forest motorways. You can see an old picture of bamboo rafting, which is amazing picture on the reservoir water. From 1980s, China began its reform and opening up. And you can see they began to use modernized machinery to process bamboo. And in Anji County, we had two parts to the story. First, we were processing the shoots, and the another part is to process bamboo. The bamboo shoot processing technology originated from the pure water processing technology. In earlier days, these were the products. In those days, you can see hand-weaved bamboo products and pure water bamboo shoots, canned foods. You can see early days, machine-made sleeping mat. Basically, very simple primary processing, and also charcoal from bamboo and the bamboo broom. In Anji County, I think the biggest highlight is comprehensive utilization. Allow me to tell you how we use every part of bamboo, from the shoot to grow into bamboo tree, and then we can fell them. It can be maybe made into, and for the shoots, we can have a seasoning of the dried bamboo shoot, and we can have all kinds of bamboo shoot products. After felling the bamboo trees, the tree leaves can be extracted and we can get leaf flavon. It can be made into drinks and health supplements. And the raw bamboo can be made into bamboo sticks and the bamboo strips. And then you can weave them into sleeping mat. The plates can be made into indoor, outdoor flooring, furniture and commodities, container plate, platform plate, flooring, and the building templates. It can be made into bamboo crafts and also can be made into charcoal for the bamboo shavings. And the raw bamboo can be used in building materials. And the bamboo branches can be processed into crude bamboo branches.
Anji also has all types of bamboo processing machineries suitable for all types of processed products. This is a special feature for Anji's bamboo processing industry. This is one of the largest processing production line in China. Along with modernized bamboo industry, from early 1980s to 2001, we have accumulated a lot of experiences. One of the important one is the contract responsibility system introduced in China in 1981, which means we contracted the land to farmer household. 91% of the bamboo forests belong to individual farmers, farmer households. By doing so, the enthusiasm of farmers being unleashed greatly. As I mentioned, the bamboo forests in Anji County, 91% belong to individual farmers. This is the first feature. Second feature is introduction of foreign investments. As early as 1985, we introduced these processing technologies from Japan. And actually this technology is still the major fundamental technologies support our industry currently. Second one, we introduced from Taiwan. All these are the fundamental underlying technologies. After the digestion and utilization by local Anji industry, those two modernized industries and technologies had formed Anji's new processing system of bamboo. As I said, until year 2000, all the state-owned enterprises being reformed, restructured, and privatized. Through this transformation, we also invite foreign investments, opening up and reform, innovation, introduction. Until that time, we have formed initial bamboo shoot processing industry system in Anji. In the reform process, bamboo shoot has been involved from handmade or manual processing into mechanized process. This is one of the most important stages in Anji. This stage took about 3 decades. This is the first ever Chinese Bamboo Culture Festival. This is a very grand scenery in 1997. This was a picture of the then Secretary General of Zhejiang Provincial Party Committee, President Xi Jinping visited Anji on site. After year 2000, especially after 2010, Anji bamboo industry has been integrated into cultivation, processing, and tourism. We established the Mosul Bamboo Modernized Park. And after 3 decades processing involvement, we have formed a modernized processing system. And for the tourism industry, bamboo plus a giant panda. So the first, secondary, and tertiary industries being integrated together, Anji is building into elegant bamboo city, stylish town, and beautiful rural village. And we have 4A bamboo scenic spots, including the Chinese Bamboo Expo Garden, Central South Baicao Garden, to name just a few. Especially, I want to talk about agritainment and also high-end special B&B, more than 60 of them, and we can provide also 600 plus agritainment, which means entertainment in the rural area. Bamboo system in Anji has become the important cultural heritage in China. This is Chinese Bamboo Museum. This is the largest and the most comprehensive bamboo museum. This is a romantic village. From the photos, you can see different scenery spots, a lot of tourism and tourist visits. This is a provincial level tourism and resort zone. This is a night scenery in Mantangling. You can see the lighting show as well. Very beautiful rural area during the nighttime. This is after the tertiary industry, the booming cultural and the creative bamboo industry. This is a film shooting studio, fashion show of bamboo products. This is a hands-on experiencing the bamboo weaving. This is a bamboo fans. Again, bamboo experiencing and this bamboo rice. We also welcome a lot of foreign visitors each year, a lot of international exchanges as well. Having said that, there are still some challenges and problems in existence in the Anji bamboo industry. The first is very extensive primary processing and also outdated equipment. And second is the overcutting problem of the bamboo. Thirdly is some over-application of a fertilizer and pesticides and so on and so forth. We are now employing diversified measures trying to improve the situation, including the intercropping. For example, we can diversify the biodiversity by intercropped tree species, and we also ban the chemical weeding measures. So a lot of ways being employed to improve the situation. That's pretty much my presentation. Thank you for your attention, and I welcome you to visit and provide guidance on-site in Anji. And I look forward to further exchanges. Thank you.
Ms. Zhang, and for your excellent presentation. And I think many friends visited Anji, and I think in China we say world Zhejiang is number one for bamboo sector in China, and in Zhejiang Anji is number one for bamboo development in Zhejiang Province. So in general, you can say bamboo development Anji is number one in the world. So Ms. Zhang mentioned many bamboo products in Anji, and I mentioned this new products, like it's a one single use bamboo cutlery, toast brush, and the new processing machines. So he summarized the three development phases in Anji. One is before 1980s. So Anji only sell bamboo cans for the market, and also the bamboo handicrafts. Between 1980s to 2010, so Anji started modern bamboo processing. First introduced this bamboo short processing technology from Japan, and might produced by machine from China, Taiwan. So it's very important for bamboo producers to invite foreign investors from China and for India, maybe for other countries. To your country, to your region, and they can bring you capital, technology, even international market. So by phase three, Anji has started to develop bamboo ecotourism. So you can, now if you go to Anji, you can see many beautiful places with green bamboo forest, and he mentioned this Mantani personally, and also Jingwei, and we visit this place, and a very beautiful village. In the evening, you can see beautiful lights, and with bamboo lampshade.
Yes, I took a lot of photos.
Mm-hmm. So thank you, Ms. Zhang, again. And the second speaker is Dr. Jiang Jingyan, and Dr. Zhang is China PhD in designing and manufacturing. He is also state senior furniture Deputy Director of Furniture Specialized Instruction Committee of National Light Industry Teaching Steering Committee of Ministry of Education, and the founder and the principal director of Yong’an Bamboo Industrial Research Institute, is a main propeller and planner of Yong’an Bamboo Sector Development. Dr. Zhang organized the compilation of eight important provincial and municipal plans, such as Yong’an Bamboo Furniture Industry Development Plan. His institute organized and hosted the 2014 to 2020 International Bamboo Fair and the International Bamboo Design Competition. Dr. Zhang's presentation is the main experience of international innovation and the development of bamboo industry in Yong’an. Dr. Zhang, please.
Hello, everybody. Hello. It's a nice, we have a chance to introduce and share some information about Yong’an. Can everybody see my PPT now? Now I share that. 听得见吗, 傅博士?
听得见。看得见这个屏幕吗?
没有。看得见。
We can hear you. We can also see your shared screen. I don't think you have shared your screen. No. We can't see your shared screen.
已经分享了。这样可以了吗?
We have a problem. We couldn't see the shared PowerPoint.
看不到 PPT.
对不起啊，我这边已经共享了。
We couldn't see it. 要不然我来分享，你来讲。可以。
Maybe I will share my screen while you are doing the presentation. Please give me a minute.
Okay.
现在可以了吗?
Okay. We can see. Okay.
Can you see the full screen?
有几块是黑的。是黑的吗?
可以的吗现在?
有几块是遮着的，我不知道是什么情况。I
don't know what happened. We can't see the full screen.
您把那个前面的有一些东西需要关掉。有黑的看不到。把其他窗口的。You
have to close several windows.
等我一下啊。Please
give me a few seconds.
调整前屏。明白。我马上。还剩一块。右上角还剩一块，然后下面还有一块。
Well, let's wait a couple of seconds for him to remove the shaded areas, the boxes.
要不先这样子好不好？不然的话，那个后面就找不到了。嗯，行，可以的，现在可以了啊。可以了啊。OK。下面还有一块啊。还有一块。Let's
wait for him to remove the shaded box.
弄不掉，我这边弄不掉。OK，we just go like that.
Sorry. I'm Zhang from Yong'an, China. Just now, Professor Zhang already introduced and shared experience bamboo industry in Zhejiang Province. Now, I'd like to introduce some information about Yong'an. And this year, including four parts. The first is about Yong'an. The second is about Yong'an's advantage to development of bamboo industry. The third is about our exploration and practice of bamboo industry. And the fourth is about the development trends of Yong'an bamboo industry. So, this evening, we have I like to send many thanks to IMBA, especially to Dr. Fu and Ms. Jing and Ms. Liu. I know that now in Hong Kong, we have a chairman of bamboo industry, Tang Tianfang. Mr. Tang also. Take part in this meeting.
哎，先生您好。
The chapter one is about Yong'an. We can see now. Where is Yong'an? Yong'an is located in South China. All about the southeast of China, nearby. Just now, Anji's County. Located in Zhejiang Province, we are in the province south of the Zhejiang. We are neighbors. Yong’an as a county, about 14 and 52. It means almost more than 600 years old. Now in Yong’an, there's a population about 350,000. This picture very similar like Anji. We can see mountains and mountains, hills and continue hills. And or most of the forestry cover is about mussel bamboo, special for mussel bamboo, just like this. This is the middle size of bamboo. And Yong’an's forestry coverage rate continually about 20 years, about 83%. Because about the people and the huge resource of bamboo, so fortunately, Yong’an occupy number one, is top one counties. Each farmers has a 0.45 hectares about bamboo forestry. All the bamboo forestry and the species about more than 98% is a mussel bamboo. So thanks for a huge resource of bamboo. So Yong’an people engaged in bamboo industry and enjoying the faster growing in their incomes. Nowadays, the Yong’an per capita income of bamboo farmers. Per farmers is about $1,200 one year. This income is account for over 37% of local people's incomes. Now we share in chapter two. Just as the Professor Zhang just now introduced, Anji is the first county in China. It's focused on trains the resource to the bamboo modern industry. Yong’an is the second counties, more than 20 years, Yong’an focus on how trains and a huge bamboo resource transform the resource to the industry, and how to use the bamboo resource to give the more chance to the farmers, to the industries, to the owners. The government also can get more tax from the bamboo industry. So this here, we again to thank for the International Network for Bamboo and Rattan, and let's IMBA. And now Yong’an is in the only top strategic partners of the IMBA. So not only about the resource, but also about the policy. In China, the government and can push the bamboo industry to make many progress thanks to the policy and to the bamboo forestry and the bamboo industry. In China, there's a famous food, it's a bamboo shot. You know, bamboo's fresh bamboo shot is only we can harvest in spring. In the summer and the autumn, we can also share, can tasting bamboo shot. Let's thank for the dry bamboo shots. So Yong'an's dry bamboo shots is famous in China. And in 1646, Yong'an is already established a bamboo shot trade fair. So this is like an association. It's an earliest association is in China. So the dry bamboo shot is occupied and a key part about the bamboo farmers' incomes. We can show this table. We know from 2004 to last year, Yong'an keep update about more than 15% growth about the bamboo industry. Last year, that's 2019, Yong'an the output value of bamboo industry reached the $1.3 billion. And tax revenue of bamboo forestry enterprise, the tax is also more than $14.7 million. Just now, Dr. Fu already introduced Yong'an's industry. Thanks many for the design competition. Yes, Yong'an already hold more than 7 years continually having a design competition. Yong'an combined with the university such as Tsinghua University, Peking University, Xiamen University, and other famous design company and designers and buyers together to design more and more new furnitures, new kitchen items, new decoration materials. Not only we designed, but also we product and marketing, how to do more marketing. And in Yong'an, there's our first national bamboo industry technology demonstration park. And this park also has a training function. We give full play to the technology incubation functions of bamboo industry. And we promote and the training the farmers how to management the bamboo forestry, how to harvest bamboo. And you can see there's many farms. That's about the different space, a different path different bureau of the governments, all the governments bureau give a good policies. So this issued by the province government to form the demonstration counties to development the bamboo industry. Yong’an, now is Yong’an is the first of a national bamboo industry and the park. Chapter three about introduce about the exploration and practice of bamboo industry development in Yong’an. Just now, Mr. Zhang, Professor Zhang, introduced the bamboo industry in Anji. Yong’an is in a different fields about the bamboo industry. And the first is Yong’an from the 2002 years. We continually set up 19 years. It's a professional bamboo is exhibitions. So until this year, we already hold more than 20 times about the professional bamboo expo. You can see in the picture. In Yong’an, there's a number one productions is about the laminate bamboo and reorganized bamboo, including platform floor and laminate lumbers and bamboo furnitures and bamboo decoration, interior decoration materials. Now, Yong’an produce more than 400 different species of bamboo productions in more than 20 series. Yong’an is famous for its bamboo platforms, especially for container floorings, truck floorings. So, Yong’an has become the largest bamboo engineering material productions, and the bamboo incense, puta, the incense stick used for puta and manufacturing base is in China. You know, this year, due to the corona virus, this year's containers, the need of the new containers. So Yong’an's container flooring, the market, we have to many orders for the new container floorings. Not only in Yong’an, the Yong’an city, but also outside of the Yong’an city, in the Middle East, in Amman, and in the mainland China, including in the South China, like Shenzhen, Xiamen, and Huizhou, we have more than 30 train stores of bamboo universe have been opened. So the people, the buyers, and the customers outside of Yong’an in the other cities can share the last, the newest productions of Yong’an. Nowadays, in China, e-commercial and internet online commercials is very famous. Yong’an is also using the internet commercials. We establish combined with the online and offline. Now, the Yong’an's e-commercial market already more than 0.5 billion US dollars now. These pictures, we can get information about Yong’an has successfully held 7 times of international Yong’an bamboo production design contest. And through the contest, we collect more than 7,000 design works from home and abroad, which provide creativity, energy from the development of bamboo industry. Not only about the university to support Yong’an industry, the local government established a special institute of bamboo industry. They named Yong’an Institute of Bamboo Industry. So our institute is a local institute to support Yong’an's industry. We can invite and combine other R&D companies, institutes, and including INBA, we can provide a technology service, including training, marketing, information. In Yong’an, NASA National Bamboo Industry IP Exchange platform. We can share, we can buy, we can show the bamboo industry IP through this platform online. So many such like these machines is already used in Yong’an's many village towns. The last chapter is about the new development trends of Yong’an's industry. Nowadays, bamboo is a renewable green resource. Through the 7 years, next 7 years, almost is usually is about 4 to 5 years growth. We can cut and harvest and use them. So the first trend is some in some productions, bamboo is take the place of the wood. The second is we may reach and development many new machines. You know, nowadays in Yong'an, many jobs is operation by human people resource. The third is we use machinery automatical through the intelligence and information and using the VR applications. So we use more the day technology. We can make more output. And the second is, you know, many bamboo counties is located also inside in the mountains. The talents is difficult to absorb them, long time stay in these bamboo counties. So Yong'an do many works to introduce in the talents. Nowadays, Yong'an is one of the most famous of Yong'an city is its bamboo furniture and the bamboo decoration for hotel, phone home, and office buildings. Just like just now, Professor Zhang says, China is a kingdom of tea. Just like this space, we use many bamboo tables, bamboo chairs, bamboo screen, bamboo lanterns. And nowadays, another productions, we can use more low bamboo columns next the bamboo building. Not only about the raw bamboo columns building, but also including bamboo laminated lumbers. Now in Yong'an, not only about the industry, but also including bamboo forestry tourism and bamboo recovering. In China, many counties, the bamboo banquet in Yong'an. So, many thanks for your attention. And these pictures. So that can link in about more information about Yong'an city and Yong'an's bamboo industry. I'm John from Yong'an Industry of Bamboo, Yong'an Institute of Bamboo Industry. And this is my email and codes you can scan. So again, many thanks for Inba, many old friends and new friends. Welcome to Yong'an. More information, we can keep contact Okay. Thanks. Thanks again.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Zhang, for your excellent English speech. And you know, Yong’an is also a very beautiful county. And Yong’an is a top strategic partner for Yinba. So in 2018, and we cooperated with Yong’an and other partners, having a beautiful bamboo park. World Bamboo and Rattan Congress in Beijing. There are 2,000 participants from many countries. So we are very happy for that. And Dr. Zhang mentioned that the advantages and the exploration and the practices of bamboo development, and also the new development trends or direction for Yong’an bamboo development. For example, Yong’an was the first cover is very high, it's 82.9% of forest cover. It's very high, yeah. So, and also 90% are mostly bamboo. This is very impressive. So also the local government has a very good policy to promote bamboo development. And from 2004 to 2019, annual increase 15% annually. This is very high. So I think Dr. Zhang's team played a very important role for Yong’an bamboo development. I think especially for the bamboo design, bamboo furniture design and the manufacturing and the marketing. So I this is my personal ideas. So if other area, if you like to develop bamboo sector, maybe you can invite Dr. Zhang and his team to help you for bamboo planning and for marketing and for design. Yeah, this is my personal recommendation. So also he mentioned the practice and the exploration for Yong’an bamboo development. He mentioned that they organized 20 times of bamboo exports. So this year we visited Yong’an during this one of the 20 bamboo exports. So it's very beautiful. And also 1 year ago, and I got the Ethiopia delegation to Yong’an and also to this bamboo furniture exhibition. So if you have time, every year they have this exhibition and competition by normally in October to November. So and for this time, when I visited Yong’an, it's very impressive for me for the bamboo transportation machines. And you know, in China, the labor cost is more and more expensive. So also bamboo harvesting is a very tough job. The younger generation don't like this job, even if you pay high salary. So what's the solution? So we have to use the machine for bamboo harvesting and the bamboo transportation from the mountain. So I get the message the local government gave the subsidy for the machine uses. For example, if a bamboo farmer buys a machine, the government can give the subsidy for farmers. So this is very good and help our bamboo industry development. And also he mentioned that this new direction, for example, innovative bamboo furniture and for office and for household. Also bamboo ecotourism like Anji. So I think bamboo ecotourism is has a bright future and for many area because everybody like a bamboo forest, like the environment, and even like the bamboo shoot. Okay, thank you, Dr. Zhang, again. And later we will ask you questions later. So our third speaker is Mr. Wu from Qingyuan Economical Corporation and the Exchange Center. So Mr. Wu helped the Qingyuan for bamboo planting and promotion. So he will share the experience. So Mr. Wu's presentation is bamboo development in Qingyuan County. And Mr. Wu, please.
大家好，听得到声音哈？听得到，吴主任，听得到。各位领导，各位来宾，大家好啊！今天呢，非常荣幸在这个第87线上这个讲座中啊，给我们浙江省庆元县。 安排了专场展示我们庆元主产业的发展。在此，对大会组委会以及来自世界各竹藤组织及国内各界参加活动的嘉宾和代表表示衷心的感谢。庆元县呢是位于浙江省南部与福建省北部毗邻，森林覆盖率达87%。 全县有竹类资源15属60多种，竹林面积有42万亩，立竹总株数有6200万株，而且还在不断的扩大，可谓呢资源禀赋优越，是中国特色竹乡。竹产业是庆元立足于地方区域资源优势产业，转化为经济优势且基础雄厚的 传统产业，是庆元县颇具优势的支柱产业集群，对庆元县经济支撑作用明显。首先介绍一下庆元县竹产业的发展现状。庆元县竹产业发展历史悠久，自从80年代初，庆元县农工乡家庭农户就开始对 毛竹加工、家家机器响、户户加工忙，盛产人工刀削普通竹筷。90年代后期，生产竹砧板、地板、装饰板为主的企业迅速发展。经过40多年的发展，目前已形成门类比较齐全、具有一定规模和水平的竹产业集群。竹产业积极 以创新驱动，建立企业技术研发中心及企业研究院，开展互联网加行动，智能化、自动化水平显著提升，竹制品总量居全县工业行业的首位。2010年3月，通过中国轻工业联合会、中国日用品 及折叠式小家具、窗帘、竹席、竹筒、竹工艺品、竹棒、竹签、整竹展开板、外贸异形、生物质颗粒产品、生物质发电等2000多种。竹制品行业共取得各项专利有3000多项，拥有国家驰名商标3个。 省名牌产品有12个，国家高新技术企业12家，在新三板及浙江省股权交易中心融资企业15家。庆元竹制品遍布国内外，近年来不断拓展。
And we are expanding our export markets. Proactively develop 1,200 e-commerce vendors with a total sales turnover of 3 billion yuan. We are setting up the industrial park for e-commerce merchants, building a very good reputation and brand awareness. In 2019, we have altogether 350 processing companies in the bamboo industry registered. Among them, 35 of them have a total annual turnover over 20 million yuan. And also 7 companies with a total output value of 100 million yuan and three flagship companies with annual tax payment of more than 10 million yuan. Altogether, they're employing 20,000 people. We have six companies whose products are among the top one in the whole country and even the whole world. Zhejiang Jiuchuan, Food Boutique, Homeware Company, Zhejiang Xinjiang, Chopsticks, Kexing, Container Flooring Manufacturing Coating, Zhejiang Zhengzhu Foldable Plate, Zhejiang Sanjian, Bamboo Handicrafts, and Zhejiang Ouya, Bamboo Furniture Co. Limited. In the whole province, the annual processing output is around 5.6 billion yuan, accounting for 55% of the total industrial output of the whole county. And we already have a multiple portfolio and a fully fledged industrial chain with electronic logistics and e-commerce and machinery and the processing machines and equipment. And the network, sales network, is covering all the cities of China. And we are continuously going to the Zhejiang and Fujian province, and also we're building a cluster of companies and using this strength to cover the whole country. We are also going to the Zhejiang, Fujian, and the Jiangxi province to basically relocating some of the output capacity to those provinces. We made great contribution to the overall bamboo industry development of the whole country. And also we are setting up an industrial park system. We are setting up five specialized bamboo industrial parks in Wudu Bamboo Startup Incubation Hub and the Pingdu Bamboo Startup Hub. And also we are building industrial park for e-commerce merchants. And we are achieving a grand circular development and a comprehensive full life cycle circular economy in the industry. And we also are developing bamboo culture and bamboo tourism. We have great potential in that part. The bamboo industry development is focusing on the concept that bamboo can replace wood. Bamboo is better than wood. That is a main feature of a local development philosophy. We are focusing on the principle that blue mountain, the green mountain and the lucy water as gold mountain and silver mountain. That is our low slogan. And I want to talk about the development opportunities we face today. First, the economic development opportunities. In the current stage is that the bamboo industry is being shifted to nearby provinces, to Fujian, Guangdong, Zhejiang, and the Jiangxi provinces and the cities. We are building regional economic alliances with them. And also we have more overseas Chinese nationals coming back to their hometown to invest in bamboo companies. That is another great opportunity to attract FDI. So we want to build a cross-region coordination mechanism featuring tighter cross-regional cooperation mechanism with a stronger application of IT, smart technology, automation technology, machinery and equipment, e-commerce, logistics, R&D, design, creative industry, and the advertising industry so that we can create a fast growing industrial cluster. And secondly, I want to talk about ecological advantages. We have the opportunity to achieve low carbon and environment friendly and green, healthy, eco-friendly economic model. People want to go back to nature, be closer to nature. We are among the top 100, the beautiful scenery and the green development counties of the whole country. Our slogan that is lucy water and green mountains are gold and silver mountain. We want to make full use of the resources and we are facing unprecedented opportunities in history. We need to speed up the development of the eco-friendly economic development model featuring low carbon environment protection, green and healthy development, build a large diameter bamboo nurturing and cultivation bases. The modernized high-efficiency bamboo and bamboo shoot dual-use cultivation bases featuring the ecotourism and with the modernized development of machineries. And we're also connecting the whole counties with the new highways. And also we have Xuning railways being built. They are creating new traffic opportunities. We are more integrated into the main trunk line of transport line of China. We are connecting with the north of Fujian province
and this will help us to remove the bottleneck of outbound transport. And we are also building Qingjing Highway, Qingshou Highway, and the Qining Railway. And we are enjoying better and more advantages investment environment and transport environment. And we are able to accept the relocated advanced manufacturing capacity from other provinces of China. And fourthly, the opportunities brought by the new era. In this new age, people have an increasing demand for culture and spiritual consumption. People want to pay more attention to their own health, which gives a lot of opportunity to develop the biotech. And the cross-regional disparity is widening and people are aging. And we are reaching the tipping point of aging population. The consumption model and consumption structure are being profoundly changed. In the new era, people want to have more needs of leisure, entertainment, sports. They want to have a better experience. And also at the same time, we have greater opportunities in the new economy, new structure, health economy, nursing economy, tourism, culture, IT, digital economy. These things are bringing new needs to the market. We need to capture these needs. Now, I want to talk about the major problems in the development of the bamboo industry in Qingyuan. The first issue is the relocation of local bamboo production capacity. This industry is focusing on the consumption of natural resources because at the current time, the labor cost is increasing, raw material cost is increasing, our competitive edge is being eroded. So a lot of industries are moving over to places where they have a lower cost with abundant bamboo resources, with a relatively greater advantage in labor costs, like Zhenghe, Shaowu, Jiangxi, Yichun, and Yiyang, Hunan province, and other counties. Secondly, insufficient raw material processing capacity. This industry is usually in the cluster. When the cluster is developing, the raw material prices will continue to grow up. And on the other hand, our output capacity is not matching this new growth.
percent of our raw materials have to be imported from neighboring counties due to the long distance transportation and the cost in transportation. It would reduce the profit margin of the processing industries. Third challenge is the company's lack of innovation because bamboo industry is a featured industry. There's no available already made technologies. A lot of new innovation needs independent indigenous innovation. However, the companies are lack of such R&D capabilities. We have zero provincial level R&D centers. We have only four like county level such R&D centers. Fourth problem is disordered competition among local enterprises because the market entry is low bar with regard to the bamboo industry. You only require a few equipment, several labors and workers. Very few companies just in pursuit of profits and produce a lot of substandard products. As a result, the good quality producers are being expelled from the market. Second problem is homogeneous competition. Because of a lack of innovation, there's a lack of new breakthroughs, new innovative products, a lot of copycats. And as a vicious circle, the profit margin became very thin. A lot of companies, unfortunately, went bankruptcy. Fourth aspect, I want to talk about solutions and recommendations for promoting high quality development of bamboo industry. It's fair to say bamboo industry is a business card industry for Qingyuan, and it can build the most beautiful garden and grow the most attractive flowers. So we need to count on
the leading companies and to have a problem resolved, to expand the market, to pay more attention to the product qualities, and to rely on industrial platform development, technological innovation, and market expansion. First and foremost, we need to support the cultivation of leading local companies. And these companies would serve as the benchmark of flagship companies. And we also will develop more influential companies with more competitive edges to provide assistance to the local companies to expand based on the total output value and taxable sales. We would categorize those companies, and we are going to make an endeavor to cultivate a leading company with the annual output more than 1 billion yuan within 3 years. In the meantime, we are going to provide more specialized and distinctive new collaborating small and micro enterprises. Second, we are going to encourage benchmarking companies to complete shareholding system reform. We are going to focus on guiding and fostering those promising companies with high quality products, and to achieve the leap forward development, leapfrog development. Third, we are going to encourage more M&A, merger and acquisition. Through M&A, we can improve companies' management capabilities and to resolve these disordered competition, chaotic situations. Fourth, we need to attract more investments to tap into the advantages of Qingyuan, including ecological, industrial, and cost advantages. We are going to have business matchmaking events, and also to understand the regional layout and advantages. And we are going to introduce and invite a large-scale bamboo deep processing enterprise. Next aspect, we want to promote more technological innovation. We are going to give full play of companies for their innovative capabilities and for their talents. We are going to raise their innovative levels. We are going to accelerate the establishment of Suncha Bamboo Research Institute and other relevant institutes and platforms, and to have those scientific results and achievements being shared among different institutes. We are going to develop various forms of R&D centers and design centers and technological centers, and also to commercialize those research results. Second, we are going to develop new collaborative innovation system for bamboo industry. We are going to strengthen cooperation and joint training with bamboo processing technologies related institutes like Zhejiang Academy of Agricultural Sciences, Forestry Institute, Zhejiang University, Ningbo Institute of Materials Technology and Engineering, and other research institutes. Third, we are going to improve the industrial research efficiency. We are going to establish a testing lab to provide services to the local enterprises. By doing so, we can increase their products standard and to actively demonstrate various scientific and technological breakthroughs and give full place of those bamboo industry as supporting, leading, pushing, and driving factors. We are going to focus on the overall layout and the special featured town And we are going to build the bamboo industry more relying on the platforms. When I talk about platform, I mean, we would try to promote more clustered development because in the master plan of our county, we have one access, two centers and three zones surrounding this overall layout. We are going to introduce more companies to this new region and also to craft such a clustered development. Well, with industry, cultural, and tourism factors. Third, building integrated display platforms to build such diversified platform by tapping into the soft power of bamboo industry in Qingyuan using different media like exhibitions, fora, and platforms. And we would also implement brand construction projects and to guide those competent companies to procure foreign brands and encourage them to develop into a famous company. We are going to cultivate, for example, those famous well-known brands through the media advertisement, their names would be known by a large population. And we would also promote the acquisition activities for those capable companies. They can buy directly foreign brands, and other companies, they can integrate the unlicensed and OEM to expand their scale of economy and operation. We would also establish a kind of a certification system with the support of relevant departments and associations. We attach great importance to the quality and safety of bamboo products, especially those bamboo food and health related products to guarantee the assessment and evaluation of those products before marketization. Fifth, we are going to expand the market by tapping into the internet plus advantages. We would guide the companies to fully use e-commerce and online trading to expand the channels of the sales of their products, and also to beef up their capabilities online. We would help those companies to organize exhibitions, exports, and marketing activities. By doing so, we can promote the brand awareness and exposure, as well as the market share of those companies. We would also develop public e-commerce platform and to guide those bamboo companies to display the products, disseminate information and trade online directly, and upgrade their e-commerce application capabilities. Third, building bamboo products a specialized market. With reference to the development model of Qingyuan mushroom market, we are going to gradually establish Qingyuan bamboo industry market on which we can transact and trade bamboo furniture, bamboo derivatives, and other products. Through the platform building, we can promote a more free flow of bamboo elements and the products. Fourth, we are going to establish the marketing organizations, and we are going to adapt into new models, establish marketing organizations, online chain stores, modern market trading systems, where the intermediaries and agents distributions are all in one. And we welcome the marketing networks, chain franchise companies, and the sales and product distribution centers to get on board from home and abroad. Finally, again, warmly welcome all the leaders and the distinguished participants to visit Qingyuan, be our guests. Thank you for providing me this opportunity.
Thank you, Mr. Wu, for your excellent presentation for Qingyuan, and it is very impressive. So, for example, if you go to Beijing supermarkets, and any supermarkets, you can find the bamboo chopping board and the bamboo chopsticks from Qingyuan. So, it's even for me, I'm surprised, yeah. So because Qingyuan is compared to Anji and to it's quite far from the capital of the province, and it's a remote county for Zhejiang Province, yeah. So before it's for my present experience, I visited Qingyuan in 1990, yeah, 30 years ago. So I spend, I take the bus, took the bus from Fuyang to Hangzhou, and then from Hangzhou to Lishui in the midnight. And then the next morning, I arrived at Qingyuan. So you can see before how far. And then now it's much better through the expressway and the train line. So Qingyuan is not so far from the big cities. And so I'm very pleased to know Qingyuan produce more than 2,000 bamboo products. And also it's a beautiful city with the forest cover even higher than Yong'an. So it's 87% of forest cover. So it's very high. So, and Mr. Wu introduced this bamboo products, and also to mention that this opportunities, inter-regional cooperation, and also ecotourism. And he mentioned also the challenges. For example, some industry move to other provinces, other regions, and the local raw material, bamboo raw material is not enough. And so they have to move transport from other region or even other provinces. So the price is increasing. And also the innovation is not enough. And the competition, the local companies, the competition for the lower prices. And so also he gave the very good suggestions. And yeah, for example, we have to promote the Dragon Enterprise. We say leading bamboo enterprise development. And so also they like to attract the investor from other big companies and build this brand and the marketing. And especially for the three speakers, and they mentioned the e-commerce. It's very important. So even in Qingyuan, and it's far from Beijing, for Shanghai and for Hangzhou. So through e-commerce, so you can sell your products to China, any everywhere, and even to the international market through e-commerce and the internet commerce. So this is a very good experience for other region. And also he mentioned this innovation talents. So you know the aspect, the people, the technician are the key factor for bamboo development. And also he mentioned this platforms establishment. So thank you, Mr. Wu, for your excellent presentation. Now we finished the presentations and now we started to question and answer. So first I give the answer to Ms. Zhang. 我先用中文吧,因为别人交流,就是张高刚就是有一个问题给您的。
Ms. Zhang has a question for you.
等一下我找一下啊。
Let me find the question.
Yeah. 就是讲政府有没有什么支持或者...
Does the government had some supportive policies? I did not catch your question. Can you repeat?
张官就是安吉有没有什么补贴或者是资金,
in Anji, does the government subsidize the bamboo industry or the cultivation of bamboo forests? In Anji, the government has a long-term support for the industry. For many years, the government is treating it as a key industry. For example, in the early days, the government, you know, in my PowerPoint, I said earlier, everything was transported by waterway. The government put money into retrofitting the waterway. Starting from 1950s, the government began to put money into building the forest lanes and roads, giving subsidies to the farmers. And this money never stopped. The government has been developing the so-called forest lanes and forest transport roads and lanes. And for every kilometer of forest lane, the government will give you 100,000 yuan to build forest lanes and roads. In terms of forest cultivation, the government has all kinds of subsidies and funding and assistance. And also the bamboo transport also received government supports. The second part is support to the enterprises. At every part of their business operation, the government has favorable policies. For example, the brand building efforts, marketing. If you want to join an exposition overseas or in other parts of China, you can get subsidies. If you apply for a patent, you can get subsidy. If you, you know, contribute more tax revenue, some will be refunded to you as a kind of reward. And if you want to introduce technology and the talents, you are building a academician professor workstation, you can get government awards. And every year, the awards are increasing. The government has been consistently doing that since the founding of the Republic of China, People's Republic of China in the 1940s. The government never stopped support. But I feel that, I mean, government support is good, but more importantly, you have to rely on your own strengths. You have to rely on yourself, rely on your products and the market itself. The government is kind of encouraging you, supporting you, guiding you. The government simply cannot run the business for you. The government is a supporter, is not the player. Thank you, Mr. Zhang. I have a question to Professor Jiang. You know, we really love bamboo furniture, but when you compare the wood with bamboo, bamboo furniture appears to be too expensive. What can you do to compete with the wooden furniture? I think it's a marketing and the marketing positioning question. I can give you an example. Currently, at my research institute, we already have one hotel. The hotel is fully built with bamboo. It is using a wooden panels stuck onto artificial wooden plates. For one night, it will cost you 400 yuan for per night stay. In Fujian province, we have another hotel called Meiyuan Hotel. They are using sole bamboo. Everything is in bamboo. For every night, it costs you 700 yuan per night. I just want to say that it depends on your positioning in the market. Some customers, they want a good value for price. They're price sensitive. Then we can use some ways to save production cost to minimize the specification. We can reduce the transaction cost by trading with futures to meet their needs. Other customers, they just want to have a premium services. They want to have a boutique services. They want to have a kind of cultural flavor. They value the design, the look of the furniture. They want to have some spiritual experience. So you can give them better products. Depends on your market positioning, targeting their different needs, different market niches or segments. Thank you, Mr. Jiang. Actually, I talked to Professor Wang in Ningbo City. Currently, they are having a smart manufacturing conversion. They have a kind of, they told me that smart manufacturing can reduce cost. So the bamboo furniture will be, on par with wooden furniture, at least on the price front. Okay, I have another question for Mr. Wu from Qingyuan. Your industry is developing really good. I guess the market, the government give you a lot of intellectual support. I just want to know, are there any good support for the cultivation and traction of talents like senior and experts to go back to Qingyuan to develop industry? Basically, your talent policy. You are muted, sorry. Currently in Qingyuan County, I told you that we face some innovation barriers. So we pay a lot of attention to talents. We really treasure, introduce, and retain talents. We have a flexible talent management policies and the mechanism. We have our local 18 article policy on nurturing talents. We're building a talent pool. We have a 2211 local talent training and nurturing policy. For example, we give you condominium. Every year we give a subsidy for finding accommodation. At the end of the year, we give you a special allowance. And also locally, we have different tiers of remuneration for like a chief handicraftsman. We have like this kind of tiered training module. In terms of technology introduction, in order to focus on innovation and create new things, we try to give more money for R&D. We give more favorable policies to the R&D companies. We motivate the companies in R&D, increase their technology content and innovation capability, build innovation platform for them, build a three-tier service system featuring county, city, and province, promote the development of traditional industry of the edible fungi and the bamboo industry, and nurture the company's innovation ability, allow the innovation players to play their central role. In 2019, we published the Qingyuan County's opinion regarding speeding up technology, content development, and science and innovation-based high-quality development model. We are optimizing the environment for nurturing innovative technology, nurture more innovative market players, increase the support for the vehicle and carrier of innovation technology, make a better system to translate innovation into real productivity, and also providing fintech services, try to improve the diffusion between technology and finance. We have 7-point supportive policies for technology innovation, help the companies to take the road of high quality, green, and technology driven development. And if you are interested in all the details of policies, I can offer you more details in future. At different periods of history, we have policy orientations. I talk about technology and the talent policies. So that is my answer. Thank you, Mr. Wu. Mr. Zhang, the second question to you. I actually try to combine the questions. People want to understand the bamboo forest, what about the farmers? Do they have to pay a rental fee for the forest bamboo land? Do they pay to the government? And the second question, can you tell us more about the bamboo forest collectives or cooperatives? Yes, in Anji in the 1980s, the bamboo forests were contracted to the households. The government does not collect any rental. The farmers don't need to pay anything, not even tax. Previously, we had a farmer's surcharge. I think at the end of 2000, these surcharges were eliminated.
After this contracting system being introduced, we have 880,000 mu, mosso bamboos, and being contracted to 60,000 households. More than 200,000 farmers own a piece of bamboo forest. You can see their bamboo forest land is very limited, small. So recently we launched this cooperative system or shareholding systems. Each individual farmer contributes their piece of bamboo land and form a kind of a cooperative and registered with the authority. Currently, we have 60 such registered cooperatives. They have reached the scale of economy and can distribute dividends every year. Thank you, Professor Zhang. Because I've guided a lot of international tours to Anji to visit your cooperatives modality. My understanding is a lot of farmers, they own the bamboo forest, but they cannot manage or operate on their own because they migrate to urban area. So they would ask the cooperative to manage on their behalf. In the long run, it would also be more efficient if they can use the machinery to do the harvesting, because individual household, their capabilities is quite limited. They cannot have the talent, technology, nor the machinery. If they can count on the cooperatives, it would drive down the overall harvesting cost. Indeed, there are some specialized harvesting cooperatives, you know, in existence in Anji. Mr. Jiang, another question with regard to the transportation harvesting machinery. Can you elaborate on this slide? Indeed.
Because for the young generation, they are not like old generation to work so hard manually by their hands. So for the transportation of mussel bamboo, we all count on the machines, and also for the pest and the disease control and the fertilizer application, even green manure application, we all rely on the machines. In the past, Yong'an government provide subsidies for the construction of forest roads. But you can imagine, since some of the mountains are quite steep, even with the subsidies, it's very difficult or sometimes it's impossible. So the government instead now provide so-called agricultural machinery subsidies, including the transportation machineries are entitled to get subsidies. Another is a machine to roast, to dry the bamboo shoots. All these machineries can get such subsidies. In recent 2 years, actually the electricity used for dry bamboo shoots can be subsidized. So as I said, all these machines, transportation machines, these can help us to protect the old traditional heritage. Because in the past, if you want to dry the bamboo shoots, you have to cut the broadleaf trees and branches as the firewood to dry the bamboo shoots. It's a kind of destruction to the ecosystems. Mussel bamboo, currently the price is 580 yuan per ton. For large diameter, sometimes it's as big as 18 to 19. If you cut this into two sections, it's a kind of a waste for the large DBH. This mussel bamboo comes. If you don't use machinery, it's impossible to transport from the top of the mountain to the bottom of the mountains. So currently government provides subsidies to the machineries, procurement, even the maintenance of the machinery are entitled for subsidies. Yes, thank you. Because I visited Yong'an, you showcased me the drying machine for bamboo shoots. And you showed us a single rail transportation, just like a cable transportation machinery. Once your technology and the machines, this integrated system is very matured, we can introduce these integrated systems, including the machinery, to other developing countries, to other places. You can sell your machinery worldwide, because a lot of I can imagine developing countries are really in need of such cost-effective machines. So with mechanized processing, we can make the industry booming again. Another question is when you visit supermarket in Beijing, you can find all kinds of Qingyuan's bamboo chopsticks and cutting boards. Even very small supermarket, you can find the Qingyuan's varieties. Can you introduce how you make your market so popular, your products so popular in the market? Please unmute. Thank you for your question. For the bamboo products, first and foremost is the quality. Qingyuan boasts very good quality bamboo products. We have 300 plus companies. They are all compliant companies, which means their products, when they enter the supermarkets, they need to be evaluated and validated. All supermarkets actually would send a kind of audit team or checking team or inspection team to Qingyuan on site to understand whether our products are satisfying their standards. So our companies, they pay a lot of attention to the market distribution. Each province, the company would identify a kind of agent company. And each year, they are going to organize trainings to the production facilities and also agent companies, and also organize some fora, workshops, and they also have some incentivized measures like awards to the company, awards to the individual employee. They also rely on professional training organizations, hire some consultant trainer. And also they have the benefits and the bonus, very good mechanism. On top of that, the local government would also help them to promote their products. We have the market supervision bureau, and this bureau would endorse their products. So those products are quite trustworthy. Also, the companies are also very trustworthy. We hope in the future, when we visit the supermarket, we are going to see more bamboo products replacing wood products, which would result in the reduction of wood use and plastic use, and also to protect our environment and increase our awareness. We also visited the Boao Forum in Hainan. In that forum, this is a very important forum and export and exhibition. Maybe Anji, you can organize a kind of delegation to go to Boao to showcase how you use your bamboo products replace plastic products, for example. And I have some also the German friends, you know, we can invite a German expert to introduce how they use bamboo materials replace plastic materials. On one hand, it can protect environment. On the other hand, can eradicate poverty by increasing farmers' income. There is a question from Philippines, and the lady, I'm not sure I pronounced your name correctly, Doris. I know you visited Anji on site. She asked, the question not directly related to the three presentations, because you also got involved in the charcoal ISO standards, because this month, December 4th, ISO approved three bamboo standards. Under the TC296, there are three bamboo charcoal standards being certified and issued by the ISO. This is really very cheering news for the bamboo industry. This is of vital importance. In the future, if we can have more standards issued with regard to bamboo products, it would expand our market. So Doris' question is asking about the PVC comparing to bamboo. Personally, I believe PVC is non-biodegradable. But bamboo winding composite pipes is low carbon products. After even several decades use, it is biodegradable. There's a colleague called Charlotte. He published a bamboo article, and the People's Daily journalist interviewed this person. He talked about two aspects. Bamboo forests compared to the fir trees in 1960s, since 1960s through the sustainable harvesting of bamboo. And the bamboo forest can sequester 300 tons of carbon, but the same forest can only sequester 160 tons. And comparing to aluminum industry, a ton production of aluminum would release 30,000 tons of carbon dioxide. So the reason I give you this example is to say more bamboo used, more bamboo produced, we're going to have more carbon sequestration, a lot of GHG emission reduction, and also energy saving.
That's why I say bamboo is environment friendly. There are many other specific questions regarding where to buy seeds, landscaping, bamboo. So I don't think we have time to go through the detailed questions. Later, we could answer the questions with emails because those are just too specific, not general enough. There's another question coming from a Canadian colleague talking about using bamboo to make bicycles. Maybe targeting Mr. Wu. Maybe he wants to visit you in future. You have the high-tech park. He wants to visit the high-tech park. Anything I missed? I really don't think it's time to ask specific questions. We only address more generalized questions. Jingwei. You are muted.
Yeah, I think there's a question. There's a question about how bamboo is differentiated from wood tree-based ecosystem in terms of watershed management. Maybe someone could answer. Zhang Gaogong,就是张高工或者是
Mr. Zhang or Mr.
Jiang?
Let us know what you think. Can you ask in Chinese again?
就是说这个竹林和
We want to know that compared
竹林和这个
with
木质的这个树种 它们
woody
在这个
vegetation
生态系统
in the ecosystem
主要是在
How are they different? Especially
就是水的
in water
水域这方面处
in watershed management
水土保持这方面的
containing water and soil. Mr. Zhang should ask answer first.
compared with woody forests? Not really. Bamboo forest compared with broadleaf woody forests, are they different in terms of containing, conserving water and soil? So you're talking about the water and the soil conservation by bamboo. Many professors of forest cultivation have done a lot of research. The ability of bamboo to conserve water and soil surpasses certain species of wood. For example, in Fujian and the Zhejiang Province, the fir tree, the mosso bamboo is conserving water and soil better than fir tree. And for broad-leaved trees, it depends on what species you talk about. In Anji County, we promote a combination, a hybridization of bamboo forests and broad-leaved trees. We are actually trying to making experiments on improving biodiversity. In the forests, we are cultivating broad-leaved trees. For example, in one mu of forest tree, we just plant three or five broad-leaved trees, and then it can contain the water and soil better. Mr. Jiang, just one small minor point. In Yong'an, on our mountains and hills, depending on the slope of the hills and the soil composition and the purpose of the management, I think in the mired slope, moderate slope area, mosso bamboo tree or the black bamboo tree forest, they actually have a better containing ability than the massam pine, than the fir tree or smaller bamboo trees. But if the slope is high, is steep, and especially you have a newly cultivated steep, I think the massam pine will be a better species to contain the water, especially when the topsoil is not very adequate, it's very shallow. So it actually depends on where you're talking about, what species you're talking about. I totally agree with Mr. Jiang and Mr. Zhang's idea. Actually, my PhD dissertation was on this topic. In my PhD dissertation, I was investigating a slope. On the top, we have broadleaves, local tree species. And in the middle layer, we have a mosso bamboo hybridized with the broadleaved trees. And then on the bottom, on the foothill, we have the mosso bamboo trees. I reviewed a lot of literature, the hybridization of two types of species are the best way to conserve water and soil. A consensus is that when you hybridize the bamboo and the broad-leaved trees with a ratio of 7:3, you will have optimal hybridization ratio. The ability to withstand a typhoon and a rainstorm, and in terms of per mu yield and water and the soil conservation and the hailstorm, they will have a better resistance. And basically, at a shallow slope, usually the interval should be no less than 0.5 meter, and also it can conserve the topsoil. As Mr. Jiang said, that if it is a steep slope, because the bamboo doesn't have very deep roots, it cannot contain the soil. It will actually lead to a mudslide. So the topsoil need to be at least a few meters deep. So if it's too steep, we need to plant some trees which are able to penetrate deep into the rock, and the bamboo will contain the topsoil layer. But at the deep, steep slope area, we need to plant other additional deeper rooted plants. We don't have enough time. So maybe one more question to Director Wu. For the businesses, enterprises, what about their tax payments? Do they pay tax? how much tax they're paying, what is the tax rate? Can you tell us? You are muted. Tax situation. Well, for these companies, they have to pay tax, of course. But the government, every year, we will take a part of the tax revenue to reward the top taxpayers. It's a kind of reward. It's not subsidy, it's a kind of a refund for the top paying taxpayers. So the rate, I don't really know the specific rate. I just know they have to pay tax. And every year, depending on, you know, your contribution of tax payment every year, the government will take out, I don't know, several dozen million yuan. And depending on your level of payment, we will reward you, give back to you. And for some companies with really good high-tech output, we have different types of awards. So it's not subsidies, kind of awards given back to you. Thank you, Dr. Wu.
Thank you, Mrs. Zhang, Dr. Zhang, and also Mr. Wu. And also, I'd like to thank our audience and for your participation and the questions. And I'd like to thank my colleague, Ms. Jingwei, Ms. Liu Qingfei, and also Ms. Guo. Ms. Guo is host broadcasting by YouTube. Yeah. So after the session, Yimba will upload the session recording online. So you can watch it on YouTube later. Yeah. So also you are welcome to our last session of this year on 22nd December, at the same time, 19 city. And the topic is bamboo and giant panda protection. This is a joint session together with Sichuan Provincial Bureau of Forestry. So welcome to join. And okay, thank you all and bye-bye.
Yes, thank you all. I think it's time for group photo. So yeah. Just now, Doctor, please open your
camera,
your video, your camera. And if you want to say something, you can say something now. I think with the 22nd giant panda session, we could celebrate our Christmas and New Year with the giant panda together. We have a wonderful year, and last time is with giant panda. That's great.
We're happy to see so many.
Oh, I saw many.
So many familiar faces.
Yeah,
thank
it's
you.
So nice to see so many.
So those.